Man, this is starting to get on my nerves. This is starting to really grind my gears. The way this season's starting to shape up here as we approach December. How many games have we played? 20, 12, and 6. So 38 games into the season. So almost halfway through. We're approaching halfway, Mark, in terms of games played. We're getting there. And yeah, I mean, 2012 and 6 is still a decent record. And we're going to be going up against a Coyotes team that we've only played one other time, but they were quite a handful in that game. We played them on the road in Arizona, and we're playing them there again. This time, as this road swing carries on here, we'll be on the road for a couple more games before we'll come back home against Chicago. But it's just not going great. We did score 3 goals against Dallas, but it was not enough. We dropped in on a fluky bounce in overtime yet again. At least we're catching some points along the way. This one, the Philly game, we caught some points here. But yeah, the road has been bumpy through the last, how many weeks now? 1, 2, 3. Last like month of the season has been pretty rocky. There can be no mercy. No mercy in this game. We hold nothing back. We're in a really just up and down stretch of play. We're not playing completely terrible. It may feel like that at times. But we just got to hold nothing back. We got to get into the win column again. We need to win this game. This is like we have to just win just for morale. Because we've dropped 3 in a row now. And we're not struggling terribly to score goals, but there's definitely more inside this team. And I guess you could say insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different outcome. But I think we got to start changing it up. So we're going to try to cycle a little bit with some of these lines. I know we came out and already fired a puck on net, but you know, you want to get started and feel things out. We're also going to approach things a little bit differently through the neutral zone. And maybe even through the D zone. Let's just be very patient with the puck tonight. Don't try to force things and make things happen that aren't there. Set up offensively. Start walking this blue line. It would be great if you guys would communicate, because then we'd actually be able to walk the blue line and set up the offense. But, you know, no one knows where to freaking go in terms of their position on the ice for these plays. I mean, we got defensemen running into each other on the blue line. We look like little kids trying to learn how to play hockey for the first time. That's what this looks like to me. Just cover the puck. Rene, welcome back to the net, by the way. Last time we were in Phoenix, we struggled. I think we got shut out 1-0. We didn't score a goal in that game, I'm pretty sure. Or something like that. It was a loss. I know we lost to Arizona or Phoenix. They were Phoenix at this time. But we lost to the Coyotes the first time around. And they're actually not a bad team based on their record in this season mode here. Their record is not terrible. Now, that's what I'm talking about. Get it down there. Start grinding away. Chip away. Grind away. But it's going to help. It's going to rely on you guys helping me out by actually going to the proper positions on the ice. And again, just can't get a shot away. Tightly defended with nowhere to go. That's another thing I forgot. I've made my defenseman pinch intentionally. I decided to go with a very aggressive pinching D on all 3 pairs. And it's kind of worked. Look at us. We got it back. Now, I'm going to cut across the middle. That's a dangerous play, obviously. Just led to a turnover. But, I mean, he didn't have any friends because we're in the middle of a freaking line change. We missed another body check. Can't keep missing these stupid body checks. Looking like clowns out here. The frustration is seeping in with this team. It really is. I'm going to just try to play a more patient game. A lot of good that's done me. Oh, come on, Rich Klune. It's on the tape, dude. I'm trying to get that puck out of the zone. That's a dangerous pass by Morris. You're lucky that worked out for you. Klune, bring in the heat. At a certain point, the puck does have to get going to the net. But we'll see. Second line here. This has Kostitsyn on it. I do think the line changes. The lineup changes. The little shift in the lineup has had a positive impact. We saw that in the last game against the Stars. Because we managed to get three goals out of our lineup by just simply making a minor change. It is a pretty major change, actually, at the end of the day. You're moving Craig Smith to the first line, and Kostitsyn is having slightly reduced minutes on the second line, but it's actually done him some good. So I think he's playing really well. Spaling, him and Kostitsyn are working really well together. I think that that could be a pretty good little duo. They might find some chemistry, but Craig Smith is back on the ice with the first line, and David Legwon taking the faceoff for the first line, winning it. But Hal Gill ripping it, of course, over the net. I want to keep that second forward in that's on the forecheck a little bit higher. And that'll be David Legwon on that, on this possession, on that attempt. Again, just looking bad. Looking plain bad. Good board pin by the AI. Now, no one's on the wing because, of course, we did bring the winger down. So I'm going to send this in. I see Legwon, but you got to skate toward the corner, buddy. Not be straight to the net. He's making a beeline right for the net. That's not the right way to go. Not the right place to be. It doesn't make that little chip in play helpful. Go. You could have an odd man rush. Nice shot on net. The net has come off, though. Just don't know. I don't know what to do about this offense. It hasn't had that spark. It's missing a spark. Maybe that spark is Shea Weber from the point. The power play is missing a spark too. And you'd think that would be Shea Weber. It has been Shea Weber for the majority of the season on the power play. Uh-oh, we've created an odd man situation. A very brief odd man situation, but Blum plays that pretty well. I'm all over the place with Kostitsyn on the wing. Defending there, but he's made himself available, and I just errant pass with Mike Fisher. Feels like I'm trying to it just feels like in these last several games, these last couple weeks in the season with the team, I've been just trying to force things. But I forced that, and did that work out? That was a beauty. And that could have been so much more. And all we get out of that possession was a slap shot from way outside from Howell's Chuck. Sums it up. Just sums it all right up. Oh, that puck's got to go to the net. I feel like maybe the easier play is just to simply take some wrist shots from outside. But the problem with this game is the AI is on top of you as soon as the faceoff is won. So, cover. We will go to a penalty kill. This has just been a problem. We're shooting ourselves in the foot. Our penalty kill is okay. But we can't stay out of the box. These last several games, the AI players taking stupid penalty after stupid penalty. Just can't get out of our own way. And of course, this would be the 13th best power play in the league. And Washington was, no. The stick did break. At least the stick broke for the Coyotes, whoever the hell we're playing. I don't even respect them that much. I don't care. I don't know who we're playing, and I don't care. I have no respect for you right now. I want to win this game at all costs. I'm pissed off with all the losing we've done lately. It's about time we won one. Yeah, we haven't gone on a win streak in a while. The last win streak we had was two games. It was going from Tampa to Carolina. Two games against Tampa and a game against Tampa and a game against Carolina. The game against Tampa was at home, and the game against Carolina was on the road. Oh, Gostad was there to pick that off. I'm trying too many fancy moves. Okay, I guess I got control of Shea Weber. I don't have control over the defending portion of the game. I'm just trying to hope for something. Hope for something I did. It's too easy for the AI to just knock you off your feet. I love that aerial flip play. I guess I should try that more often. It's only a sensible play if someone's going like that, especially on a penalty kill where you're going to clear it anyway. Nothing is getting through Mike Smith. Yep, I'm going to stay here. I'll poke all night. What are you going to do about it? That puck is going over that goal line at some point tonight. It is going over the goal line tonight. Maybe my famous last words, I guess. Nice puck chop. Hold the phone. How's that a penalty? I think this is another AI penalty. You can't see it, but I am face. Oh, come on! What? He's just making a puck chop. This game is so unfair, dude. It's clearly, we're not supposed to see any success. I don't mind that. Nice little shot. Go back in, get it, leg one. Oh, please be on the point. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. You know, with a penalty kill, I probably should not have done that. Oh, I should have had a poke check there too. Don't let him set that up. Save by Rene. I'm going to get this out. Don't worry. Getting this out. Okay. God, Colin Wilson. That was not supposed to be the way that went. Oh, no. Oh, boy. This is something. This really is something. Mike Smith. Delay of game. That happened the last time we were here. The last time we were here, that exact same thing happened. There's a great frequency for certain goalies in this game to play the puck, and Mike Smith is one of those goalies that's so hot. Is that Biz serving the penalty? Mike Smith is hot to play the puck in this game, and that's something we can take advantage of. If you just bull rush him, he will flip that thing out of play. It happened last time we played a game in this building. He was a goaltender, and he straight flipped it out of play in that game too, just like that. He has a lot of desire to play the puck, but no competency in playing it. All right. Oh, okay. Go with the last minute of the period. All right. I got no friends, so I guess I'll just shoot it. Smith just rubs that out of the air and almost played it into his own net. He can't even play the puck properly in his own goal crease. Drop pass. Ew. I got it. Come back for it. You guys have got to come back to support the play. They're just all over us. Please. I need a goal. The power play needs a goal. Mike Fisher! This AI is a different level. This is brilliant stuff. It's neutral zone face-off, too. I got no words for it at this point. I got no words for this. Oh, yes. Yeah! Kostitsyn! Power play goal one time. It's about freaking time. All that feels really good. Like, that is the most gratifying thing I've seen happen in this game in a long time. Maybe moving Kostitsyn to the point is exactly what the power play needed. It's the perfect juice for the power play. I told you, win at all costs. Lineup changes to perfection. Music is stopped. That's awkward for me. How about that? A power play goal to end the period, and it comes from 74, who has been very reliable on the power play, might I add. Did we take... We took a penalty, right? It can't even end the period properly with just a little bit of optimism. I don't know what to tell you guys, but you want to just keep going to the freaking penalty box all night. They're keeping some real good stuff in there tonight, aren't they, guys? And it was a third consecutive AI penalty. I didn't take the penalty by controlling a player. It's an AI-controlled player that took that penalty. I'm going for it shorthanded. Win at all costs. Score as many goals as you can. Do what you have to. I just got to rim that back in. I know you're going to take a hit to make that. That could have been interference. You could argue that should have been a penalty. Don't give them that much space on the break-in, especially with a power play. Good over there, Weber. You got to cover a pass or a shot off. No, Bodkurt. No, puck bounces straight up in the air. What the hell? I've never seen that. Oh, your stick's broken. You're the one that broke the stick with leg one. Well, your little stick block was perfect, and the net has come off in the Arizona zone, Phoenix zone, whatever. This is crazy. This game has something's happened to it. It's on drugs right now. I need to be on drugs just to play this. I'm going to help out with the defenseman. That's really risky, of course, on a penalty kill. Do I regret doing that? No. Win at all costs. That's the mantra of this game. Win at all costs. Do what you have to win the game. Oh, Colin Wilson. Now, do you like that little move? That was sly. Yeah. Fist pump in the net. And Colin Wilson has staked us to a two-goal lead, his fifth of the year. It does come at even strength. It was right as the penalty had ended. That little crossing move. He did a little stop-up right there, then had the defenseman caught out. And then I think McCulloch screened Smith as well. So it's been a long time since Colin Wilson's been on the score sheet. It's about freaking time. You need your depth to come through, especially when you're struggling for offense. You just got to find ways to use your depth to score goals. All right, they're coming really hard after us on the forecheck, so I'm just going to back up, create some space. Yeah, do you like that? You like that, Mike Smith? Oh, tip in front. Okay, I like it. I mean, this is better than what we've been doing in the last several games. I can say this. We've got two goals already. We're looking good to maybe get four, and if we can do that, I like our prospects of winning this game. Now, stay with me, Kostitsyn, because you're going to... Oh, you're almost going to score. Should have had a goal there. There was a perfectly placed rebound. I'm going to send this down low. Kostitsyn get off the net. Oh, well. Hey, I'm trying to feed the guy the puck and give him opportunities to score goals. It's in front of the net now. Smith to Spaling. We're just trying to be a little too unselfish now with it. Should have just wrapped it around. Good play by Gill. That's a tough spot. Good block. Up the zone. Talishek, just flip it in. We got no help, no speed. I'm going to shadow this guy up the ice with the forecheck. Nope, you're going to be forced to dump that in. Can we move it quickly, Gil? Move it there. More. Move it again. There we go. Oh, Halaschuk, you got to have your stick on the ice or you would have had a breakout. Fisher almost had an interference penalty called against him. Gil against Moss. I'm not sure who the player is. Just trying to remember some of these names of some of these old Coyotes players. Klune with no friends. Just rips one into the glove of Mike Smith. Morrison was standing right in front on the point. Right in front. Well, that was an interesting play to try and chip it up the boards or up the glass and out. Sorry that we just looked... Slop. Oh, go. Don't waste this opportunity. Don't waste it. And he didn't waste it. He did get a shot on net. Yeah, it's better than missing, but it's still not a goal. You would like to have those breakaways to score a goal. We needed a little more breakaway speed than we had. Oh, the poor leg of... Oh, Craig Smith. He's gone from the game. That's a player we can't afford to lose. And his goal scoring streak is going to end because he's not going to score a goal in this game now. He's gone from the game. It's not that severe. Come on. Yeah, I know. I know, Craig. You're just trying to make a hard play. Just finishing your check. It's the weak sauce from the referees, if you ask me on that. Well, it's 5 minutes. I'm not killing 5 minutes of this game by just simply clearing the puck for the whole 5 minutes. And you might as well shoot it. Colin Wilson has a goal that almost came shorthanded earlier, so why not? Have a blast. Have a rip on the net. Now, I'm not saying that we need to just have a free-for-all with this penalty kill, but I'm not going to sit back and hang back for the whole 5 minutes. You know, if we're going to take a major penalty... Uh-oh. Well, it would help if we don't score on our own net there, Shea Weber. But if you're going to take a major penalty... I don't think you should sit back on a major penalty unless you've gotten scored on in the major penalty. Then you have to kill the rest of it, however much time remains. Then you kind of sit back a little bit. But I say why not? Let's just go for it. And we are going to get scored on in the major penalty. I knew that was coming, I guess. Yeah, no one's there. No one's covering Moss in the slot area. That's what's going to happen. You leave a guy wide open in a prime shooting position, it's going to go in. Okay, well, revert what I said. We're gonna clear the puck now. They scored pretty early in a major penalty. So we are going to clear the puck now. We're actually going to play proper D. They're going to dump it in. I'm going to feed this all the way out. Okay, no, I'm not, because we're just going to take our sweet time, Roman Josi. Let's take our sweet time with a penalty kill. This is pissing me off. I got to be careful with these flip dumps as well, these flip clear outs where we're going to flip it off the stick blade. If I'm not careful, it does go over the glass. It's a delay of game. We're already in a major penalty kill situation. No one's covering the backdoor guy. No, I finally got there with Josi. Now, can we please clear this? Thank you, Josi. God. Mike Smith's not taking a delay of game penalty there. It's so sloppy. It's so sloppy. It's so bad. Oh, I had the stick on Ekman Larson. I got stick on puck. It just didn't come free. There we go. We took Bodker briefly off the puck, but it seems like no matter what we do, we can't get the puck to be jarred loose long enough to go recover it. We will get it now. I'm going to 10-2 this. No, I'm not. This is comically bad from our team. One major penalty in the whole game seems like it's falling apart for us. Rene! It's because the game is falling apart for us. Why did you have to lose your balance on that? Tie game. Craig Smith's major penalty has actually been super costly. We were in control of this, and now we're not. The game is crapping all over everything that I've worked so hard to achieve in this. Hal Gill should have had a goal there. He should have 100% had a shorthanded goal. Oh, good. Good to see we can actually have proper rebound control, Rene. Good we can have rebound control. Should have had it on the goal that was just scored by Vermette. That's an icing. That's an icing. That's 100% an icing. Doom music is appropriate right now for me, because that's exactly how I'm feeling. Enraged. Yeah, you can feel that one tomorrow, whoever blocked that. Good luck with yourself. That should be a penalty. They hooked Gostad. 100% they hooked him. Referees are ignoring it now. They can call a major penalty on Craig Smith for making an honest play, but they can't call a hooking penalty when one is needed. Oh, can't even get out of trouble. Look. Oh! God knows, man. This is something else. It really is something else. We're just fighting to break the puck out. That's where we're at right now. We're just fighting to simply make a breakout play. Leguan can't handle a tape-to-tape pass. Falling apart. Right at the seams. I need better support through the middle on that play, on that breakout. I really did. Oh, took forever to get there, and it never even got there to begin with. That was a risky pass initially, but hey, it's worked. There we go. Oh, Borg, come on. Dude, we just need to make simple plays, and we're not even making simple plays. I leave an easy drop pass for you, and you miss it completely. Oh, the penalty's coming up. Finally, a penalty of Phoenix. Now, we did score on the power play, and it was Kostitsyn on the one-timer. Are we 1-for-1 on the power play? I think we're 1-for-1 on the power play. Yes, we are. Okay. Sergei Kostitsyn, it's time for you to step up again. Craig Smith's not going to be out there because he's gone from the game with a major penalty and a game misconduct. So he's gone. He's done for. Where are you going? Where is Shea Weber on the freaking support play to break the puck out from the... AI is just nowhere to be found on the most simple, on the most simple and basic of play. That's got to go in. I mean, I'm about to get heated. It's making me lose brain cells playing this. Fake the shot. Just go. Oh, I wanted him to go right to the net. All right, Kostitsyn, you want your second of the game? Get your second of the game. Yes! If it's not Craig Smith, at least Kostitsyn's showing up in place of Craig Smith. He has his 17th of the year, second power play goal of the game. Second goal of the game as well. That's just me being straight fired up to just shoot the puck. I'm just, sometimes just playing this game, I just have enough. And I've had about all that I can take playing this game against Phoenix. The penalty calls against us, the plays that just haven't gone our way. Finally, the power play has been very seductive tonight. I enjoy that aspect of this game. I didn't even mean to get that decline, and it almost did get decline. Oh, Wilson, fire it. Go in. Oh, where was the puck? It was not behind Smith. I thought it would be behind Mike Smith. Can we get this onside and get a shot on net? No, we won't, because we're just going to stumble around at the blue line with it. But we got a lead thanks to number 74. I can't believe I'm actually saying it. It's a miracle. Sergei Kostitsyn has a multi-goal game. I don't know the last time I could even say Sergei Kostitsyn had a multi-game goal game. I don't know the last time that I could say that Sergei Kostitsyn scored a goal in a game. Actually, that's not true. I do know that he did score in the... That should have been a touch for Kostitsyn. He's going to win out the... Get a hat trick, bro. He almost did. But Kostitsyn scored not too many games ago in the victory we had over Chicago. I think the Chicago game. He scored a goal. Yeah, they're just right on top of you when the faceoff happens before you can even do anything with it. It's not even fair. And they will cross-corner this. Now, Josi picked the puck up. Wow, he actually picks the puck up in the corner. Left that for Wilson. It's going to be behind Bork, so no speed here, but that's fine. We need to just get teammates in. I don't know what I was looking to do on that play. But, hey, whatever. Halaschuk, keep it in. They're right on top of us. Their D is just right on us in the D zone. They're doing a really good job with it. Become extremely frustrating playing Arizona. Phoenix, whatever. It's Phoenix Coyotes in the state of Arizona, the city of Phoenix, state of Arizona, whatever. Same old, same old. But they play in Glendale, which is not even close to Phoenix. And I've been to both Phoenix and Glendale, and they're not even close. And that drive in work traffic from Phoenix to Glendale is terrible. If you've never done it, it's terrible. During rush hour, it's crazy. So I don't know what the move is. Just send it down low, but see, they got a defense. That was really super creative and ingenious, and almost too ingenious for this season mode. We could have scored on that. Good stick, but again, the bounce just not in our favor. Kaminsky's going to the right spot. He's a defenseman. Oh, he had it there. Rich Klun, one-on-one. I think so. And then he lost it, because it's just so easy for them to just nudge you right off the puck. Gonna have to move the puck faster than that, but that's a clean hit. Surprised they didn't give him a game misconduct for that. All right, David Legwand scores short side, and an assist for Kostitsyn. He's had a huge game. This is a great game for Kostitsyn. It's a reprisal of his top line role, even though he's playing on the second line. He's playing like a guy that should be on the first line. I will keep this game in consideration, but for now, you're going to remain on the second line, because why change what's working? And except both of his goals in this game have come on the power play, so that's just him scoring with the man advantage, but it's working. We got his confidence restored. He's clearly playing like an elite player now. And I told you that he needed to contribute. You need to contribute in other ways if you're not scoring goals. Contribute in other ways. And then the game, the rest of it will take care of itself and you'll get your goal scoring touch back. He's got his goal scoring touch back. So, figured something out. Got four goals in this game as well. Should be enough to win. You would think we almost have five because we had Bork there on the back door. This line is really, this is the third line. But they're playing like a grind line. I also changed strategic settings before this game. I changed our entire strategy defensively and offensively. It doesn't matter on that play. That was just a rebound. Rene has looked kind of bad in this game. I'm not going to lie. He has looked kind of bad in this game. He's fallen all over the place. On two of the goals that have been scored in this game, he's fallen all over the place. Why are you trying to make a fancy split save here? It's not necessary. Look at how much net you're leaving open on that rebound. But I mean, I changed our strategy offensively. I changed our strategy in terms of how we're going to make our defensemen pinch. It's working. I mean, we're playing a lot better like this. We've made lineup changes as well. That seems to have paid off in dividends. And yet we're still in a one-goal game. So, I mean, I said you'd think that the four goals would be enough to win a game, but apparently not. Two goals for David Legwon. Now, it went right to him. It was a fluke play, but we got our two-goal lead restored. And it's not Kostitsyn that's got the only two-goal game. Legwon has a two-goal game. He gets his 14th of the year. He's right up there with Kostitsyn now. I totally forgot about Legwon. Both of our centers, our top two centers, Legwon and Fisher, are both sneakily good. You wouldn't think they'd have as many goals as they have this year, but they do. And Legwon, I know coming into this game, had 12 on the year, but now he's got 14 just like that. And looking very, very solid as a center. You know, you don't always expect, especially a player like David Legwon, you don't expect him to score a ton of goals. And I mean, oh, no. Don't do that to me. It's freaking Gabe. But you don't expect him to score a ton of goals. 14 isn't a ton, but you know, we're only at the halfway mark in the season. Who's to say that he couldn't score 30 this year? He very well could. Yeah, these changes strategically have worked out beautifully. I'm trying to force the puck into areas where it's just not going to go. So that's my fault on that end. Got to be careful with that stick. Beautifully defended by Hal Gill. That's how we need to defend every time off the rush. They're going to bring it into our zone and we're going to make them earn it. Out the zone. I'm pressing a pass button, but it's just not going. It's just go. That was a good play. Found Kostitsyn there. It's just, we're not forcing it as much now with Kostitsyn. That's the nice part about it. I don't have to force these plays. Oh, I pressed the pass button, but he was getting knocked down at the exact same time. Save by Rene. Oh, Rene looks so shaky. Have we just played him to a point of total fatigue that he's going to need a few nights off? We went to Mason in the last game, and he was okay. He was pretty good. Good enough. We could have won the game with Mason in the net in the last game. We're going to not win this race to the puck. Clean body check. Oh, had it stripped off of McCulloch. Still plenty of game left for the Phoenix Coyotes, so I don't want to get too comfortable even with that two-goal advantage until this game really winds down in the final couple minutes. Nice puck chop. Go, 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 go. Careful when we're centering it through the middle like that. All right, I'm gonna send it down low. Halaschuk over to Bork. Intended to get it across the board. Just 4 minutes left. Just grind out this 4 minutes. I'm gonna try to quickly advance this. Oh, nice pull by Blum. That's what we want on the breakout. Yeah, you gotta hustle to the net a little bit more hurriedly than that if you want to score a goal. But I'm fine with that play. We just killed time. We had a good look on the net. Oh, there could have been a goal there. I'm gonna flip this. And Mike Smith is gonna come out of the net and play it like a madman. David Legwand's also looking for the hat trick. I got to remember that. Legwand is looking for a hat trick. I feel like the man that needs it the most is Kostyts and just need to get him a huge three-goal night to make up for some of the games where he hasn't scored. And a fan on that pass all the way back to the point. If Kostyts was up there, he would have had a breakaway. He would have been right on top of that. And we'll take a face-off. I think it's a good idea to just hold on to the puck. A minute left in the game. Melt this thing away. Top line is back out there. Oh, no, this is the second line, so we still got Kostyts out there, which means he could be in the running for an empty net goal. And he almost made that move successful. Now, trying to pull these dekes off, they sometimes these dekes happen too slow, which is the problem with some of these dekes. Oh, go get that. Save off a Spaling stick. Good save by Smith. Oh, Kostyts, you had it, and he rifled it. Oh, we're just going to get Kostyts in that goal without the empty net. Don't need the empty netter. The net will be empty now. I think we're making a bunch of line changes behind the scenes. Up to Wilson. Oh, no, it went off the stick of Bork. There won't be anyone padding any stats tonight. Nope, won't be padding any extra stats, but we'll take the victory. Finally break up this awful stretch of losing with a really solid road win in Phoenix. Making up for the fact that the last time we were in this building, we did lose. And we got Kostyts in a couple of goals. We got Legwand a couple of goals. Very nice little bounce back win showing we still got it. Although Rene looking very shaky in the process. We're going to have to consider giving him a couple of nights off in a row.